Welcome back, everyone. Here we are in our video solutions for Cisco exam questions. So here's our next question. What is one difference between SSH and Telnet? The answer, SSH encrypts all data transmitted while Telnet encrypts none of the information. Yes, SSH, and I'm gonna show you how you do this now, how we do this, okay? You set the encryption level, all right? You do what's called crypto keys, okay? And every communication that you have with another person, it will be encrypted. That's the way it should be. Telnet, you know, it's still around, port 22, SSH, port 22, SSH, Telnet is 23, sorry. 23, SSH is 22. I just ate lunch, so carbs. All right, so how's this done? First of all, your router has to have a host name. You gotta have a host name, all right? And you need to create a local username, or you have to create a username. That's the whole point, authentication, okay? You need to create encryption keys, but before that, you have to have a domain name. You need to create the domain name, and that's why it's in this order. I don't know why I skipped it. It has to be, you know, host name, domain name, local username, and then create your keys. Because if you try to create your keys before you have your domain name, it's not gonna let you create it. It says can't do it because it uses the combination of the host name and the domain name to create the key. Now, when you're creating the key, all right, when you're creating the key, it's gonna ask you, by default, it puts it at 512, right? It's in the brackets, 512, you'll see it in a second. But you can make it bigger if you want. But if remember, always keep this in mind. Always keep this in mind. The bigger you go, the more encryption there is, the more processing is going to take place. All right. Then you configure your SSH. All right. And then you configure your VTY lines, which are your telnet lines, your terminal lines. But so how exactly do we do this? Okay. So we all know, or we should know, how to configure host name. There you go, R1. IP domain name, cisco.com. All right, so that's my domain name. Here's a username. Username, LDS, privilege 15, which is the highest privilege you can have. Password, and you have to put, you don't have to put, but 0 means plain text, Cisco. But again, using service password hyphen encryption, it encrypts it for you, and we're using SSH anyway. All right, so you created a username. Now you do your SSH. So you do IP SSH authentication returns. How many times are you gonna allow this person to try and log in using certain credentials? 3 times. IP SSH timeout. Well, how long are you gonna let them sit there without doing anything before that session times out? So that's the maximum 120 seconds. And here are the keys. Now, crypto key generate RSA, and then at that point you can hit enter. And then it's gonna give you this big thing. It says, okay, well, how big your keys wanna be? And the default, I always pick the default. Oh, RSA, I'm sorry, RSA. And then the default, I just leave it at that, 512. I hit enter, all right? Once you've done that, you go to your line VTY, all your telnet lines, whatever, however many you have or however many you wanna allow, all right? Log in local to use the local username and password. Give it a name, a password if you wanted to. And then key point, transport input SSH. That is how you're gonna make it use this SSH. If you do not put this, then you're not gonna be able to SSH. So how do we SSH? Well, there it is right here. SSH minus L, which is means list. Who? Me, LDS. To what IP address? 192.168.100.254. Then it's gonna ask you for the password. And look what happens, because I have level 15 privilege and it's secure. Well, just because I have a level 15 privilege, really, I'm in privilege mode. Yes, privilege mode. And we'll talk about this little pound sign a little later on, but privilege mode, okay? So that's the difference. So straight up answer, SSH encrypts, Telnet doesn't, okay? That will be the answer to that question, this is the things you need to do, and you saw it over here to create it, okay? That's it. Simple as that. See you in the next one.